Alright, great job so far. We learned about a lot of different classes. Just going to complete that part here. We're going to be learning about the special class called Enum. So what exactly do Enum do? It is just simple ways to control and store simple constants that are not going to change throughout the lifetime program. So we're just going to store this constant for us and just give a simple way to access these constants such a way that user or whoever is actually trying to create a method cannot go ahead and create a lot of different constants that is going to be present. It's just cleaner way to do store constants, and that's what you're going to see in this video. It's a very simple, straightforward video. Make sure you stay till the end and watch it and learn about that. Let's get this video. I'll just take you to the slides here and just learn about enums and come back and summarize.
Alright, so what are enums in Dart? These are nothing but enumerated types, often called as enumerations, and these are special kind of classes used to represent a fixed number of constant values. So what exactly are constants? They're not some values that are not going to change throughout the lifetime of a program. Say you have a variable x is equal to 10, and this variable is not going to change the value at all, and nobody can change it. So when you have something like that, you make use of the enums in that place. These are very simple ways to actually create cleaner programs and not just float around values that will use or impact a user scenario. For example, let's assume that there is a simple input value where you have to enter your country, city and state. When that's going to be the input value, we need not or we shouldn't actually let the user enter his own value. We can say that country is going to have country's specific section, city's a specific section, and similarly state is also a specific section. So in that scenario, we would actually control the inputs here, the country, city and state, through the use of an enum. So how do you create an enum? This is very simple. Just use the keyword enum followed by the name for that enum. I have written here it is an accepted input, so I'm just going to say enum space accepted input. Inside that, I'm going to define the three different ways that I want it to be defined. Country is going to be one, city is going to be one, and state is going to be one. And I would directly make use of the dot notation to access these values. So I'll just say accepted input dot country. If the accepted input dot country is present, then user can enter the country name. Accepted input dot city is present, they can enter the city name. Accepted input dot state is present, they could enter the state name. So that's going to be the way to create, rather than just floating it around as a string, which is not at all accepted. It's also a way better way to clean and write code that is going to be modularized as well. So let's go to my Dart pad here. Let's have it's a very simple straightforward video. So just use enum here, just enum keyword followed by accepted input state or something like that. Use the flower brackets and define the three states that you want to define. So I'll just say country, city and state. So when you do that, you just go here and you could directly call the accepted input. No need of creating any instantiations here. You cannot instantiate a enum. See, already this showing us the three available states. So just put input.country, something like that. When you print, it'll print the value of accepted input.country, which is nothing but a string by itself. So when you do that, you can just now confirm that if the accepted input.country is equal to some space, some scenario, then do that scenario instead of actually getting a string from the user, and which is not going to be making use of any making sense at all. Now, one more thing that you can do with enums is that you can actually get the index from which that place that enum value is present. So the example state here dot index, if you print, it will print the space where that state is present. So it's actually present in the index 2, right? 0, 1 and 2. So that way you could control that as well, and you can actually go ahead and write any number of programs that you want to do. So again, like I told you, enums are very, very useful when you're actually creating huge programs and you're going to get a value from the user. So let's assume the void main is going to be user input. User wants to enter the value for a city. Instead of passing the values as like this city, you could instead pass accepted input city, and the method is going to take care of this and actually give the value for that. So that's the main use case here, and that's what you learned as well. Alright, so very, very fast video, just a simple definition of what enums are and how they are useful. Let me go back and summarize it for you guys and end this video out.
Phew, that was the fastest video in the series, right? So just enums are very useful. Make sure you learn about more about them. You'd find any super cool or any super huge program definitely having enums, because enums are going to control the input from the user. They're not going to just allow any input to be coming into the method. That way, they just control the method's input variables, and we are actually very much sure that the method is not going to break anywhere. So that's the main use of enum. These are special classes again, so make sure you understand that part. and let's end this video out. So I'm going to be taking up guys to the next important section from the next upcoming videos. So make sure you stay tuned for that. Let me meet you there. Until next time, peace out.